Hello, and today we are with Mr. Richard Clarke, who is the General Manager of the Tune Hotel Liverpool Street. Good morning to you, Mr. Clarke.
Good morning.
Now, first of all, I have to say congratulations. You soft opened, just 3 days ago. So congratulations on that. What is the soft opening and what is it? How will it differ from the grand opening? What facilities are not completely open at the moment?
The soft opening is designed to make sure that my team are fully ready and prepared. We haven't opened the whole hotel at the moment. We haven't got the lower ground and the ground floor available to guests. However, floors 1 to 4 are available now. So it's given us an opportunity to get used to working together, making sure that we're working towards the brand standards of Tune Hotels and ironing out any issues that may arise from that, from the construction point of view.
Right. Now, this is the second Tune Hotel in London. There's the Westminster Hotel as well, which opened in August 2010. How do the two hotels differ?
They do differ. We've learnt some valuable lessons from Westminster. Westminster is running at a very high occupancy and is a very successful hotel. However, what we've tried to do here is listen to the comments from the guests who have stayed at Westminster and incorporated that into the hotel here. For example, the rooms are slightly larger and the furnishings as well are slightly different. And we're very confident that the guests staying at Liverpool Street here will be very happy with what we've done.
Right. Now, of course, now that you are expanding and then there's hopefully another two or three hotels opening next year, Tune Hotels opening next year, 2012. With this expansion, obviously it comes down to location very much, doesn't it? What is there to do in this Liverpool Street area for tourists and for business travellers that are here as well?
Yeah, we are very lucky with the location that we have here. For the corporate market, we're very close to the main Royal Bank of Scotland and the financial district in Bishopsgate, which is a couple of minutes walk away from the hotel. But from a leisure aspect, we do have a lot of markets in the area, such as Spitalfields Market and Petticoat Lane. We also have Brick Lane, famous for the curries here in London. So there's plenty to do regardless to whether you're staying here on corporate business or just enjoying London from a leisure aspect as well.
Right. Now you have a couple of, the tube station's not far away. There's the Liverpool Street station, which is, just over 500 metres, I believe, or so. It's a few minutes walk anyway. If you're coming from Heathrow or Gatwick, what is the best way to get to the property?
The best way will be taking the London Underground. As you mentioned, we are very lucky to have Liverpool Street Station about a 5 minute walk away from us. There you have the Central Line, Hammersmith and City. You also have the Circle and District lines as well, and the Metropolitan line. We also have the Stansted Express, so if you're flying in from Stansted Airport, you can take the Stansted Express that brings you straight into Liverpool Street. So we are very accessible for our guests to arrive at the hotel.
Right. Now, if you're coming in from Gatwick or Heathrow, you mentioned Stansted, how much time roughly should one dedicate to travelling from the airport to the hotel?
It does depend on what time of day you're travelling. Obviously, during the commuter hours of a morning and of an evening, it may take slightly longer. But I would recommend that you leave an hour to an hour and 15 minutes travelling time on the tube, just to make sure you're here in plenty of time and to catch your on with flights.
Right. Now, obviously, the tube and the buses, and there's also the cabs as well. That's one way for the travellers to get around. But I have noticed there's a lot of Barclays bikes in this area. There's a couple of stations that I've noticed. Could you tell us a little bit more about these Barclays bikes, please? And is it something that you recommend for tourists?
Absolutely. We're very proud of the Barclays bikes. It was introduced by the Mayor of London. Many tourists take advantage of the bikes. We have two stations very close by to the hotel, one in Bishopsgate and one in Shoreditch. The first 30 minutes is free of charge, and then there is a small fee depending on how long you wish to use the bikes for. You just pop your credit card into the machine and that will release the bike for you. And then when you're finished cycling, you can just return that to one of the stations which are dotted around London, where you can then return the bike and be on your way.
Excellent. Now, is it safe to cycle in London? Because, I mean, you have to be quite brave. It is a major city. It's a busy city. There's a lot of traffic on the roads. Is it safe?
It is safe. More and more cycle lanes are being introduced onto London roads now. This is something that the government has introduced in the past year, few years, and to coincide with the Barclays Bike scheme. So it's becoming more and more safe. However, we would recommend using safety helmets and so on the streets of London.
Right. Okay, now here at the hotel you have 183 rooms. How do the rooms differ? If you could just please explain to us how the difference between the rooms and what the average size of the rooms here are, please.
Absolutely. The average room size here is 11 square feet. The rooms differ. We have double rooms and twin rooms. The twin rooms consist of two single beds. We also have rooms here that offer windows and rooms without windows as well. The rooms without windows do differ in price, where they'll be a little bit cheaper than the rooms with windows. We do have some larger rooms as well, and we also have accessible rooms as well available.
Right. Now, obviously, Tune Hotels is famous for as pay-as-you-use services and what have you. What is included and what's not here at the hotel?
Okay. When you book online, you'll see that you can book a comfort package. The comfort package is £7, and that will include TV use, a towel, Wi-Fi, a safe, and hairdryer. If you don't book the add-ons at the time of making your reservation on the internet, you can do this on the desk as well. My team are always on hand to make sure that we make your stay as comfortable as possible.
Right, and is it the same price if you don't do it online at the time of the booking? Is it the same price when you do it in the reception?
Absolutely, it is the same price. We just want to make sure that it's convenient for our guests. So whether you make the decision at the time of booking or make the decision at the reception desk, it will cost you the same amount.
Okay, now I believe you're one of the few Tune Hotels that actually includes the air conditioning. Is that correct?
That is correct, yes. We're very proud of the fact that we make sure that we look after the comfort of our guests. We make sure that there are some items where you will need to pay extra so you can modify your own stay to your needs. However, we feel that the key aspect of the comfort for the guests would be to have air conditioning in all of the rooms, especially the weather we sometimes get here in London. Sometimes it's nice just to make the room a little bit warmer in the summer months, just that little bit cooler as well.
Right, now you mentioned there the heat, because obviously here we are, it's almost New Year's Eve. It is a bit chilly in London, especially if you're coming from the Asia Pacific countries. When we talk of air conditioning over there, it tends to be to cool the room. So do I understand that these air conditioning units also heat the room as well?
That's correct, yes. Every room has its individual unit, so you can control the temperature of your own room, which is on a panel next to the door as you arrive into the hotel room. You can increase the temperature or decrease the temperature, so your comfort is always met.
Okay, now let's just talk about extras for a moment, stay on this. Towels, are they included?
They're not included, no. There is a small charge for towels. Some of our guests do actually bring their own towels, but we have towels available on reception. If you haven't already pre-booked this, we will ask you at the reception to make sure that if you need them, they'll be available for you, and right, then you can just bring them to your room when you arrive.
Right, now of course a lot of people are very concerned that they'd arrive here and then there's like the extras, the towels and the Wi-Fi and the safe, it becomes a little bit expensive. What sort of prices are we looking at, for example, for the Wi-Fi and for the towels? How much would they be?
For the Wi-Fi, it would be £3 for Wi-Fi access for 24 hours. However, what we do is offer £10 unlimited use for the Wi-Fi as well. And in comparison to a lot of hotels in this area, that is considerably cheaper. For the towels, it's £3.50 for use of the towels there. As I mentioned earlier, we do offer a comfort package, so you can package this up so you'll have all these amenities for when you arrive in the hotel.
Right. Now, you do have a small snack shop in the lobby, but there are obviously around this area there are just a multitude of different types of restaurants. People though do tend to be a little bit lazy. They do like room service. Have you linked up with any restaurants to offer a delivery service to the room?
We haven't linked up with any restaurants to offer a delivery service. However, we have been speaking to an Asian restaurant, which is about a 5-minute walk away from the hotel, called Funky Asia. We're very keen to work closely with them and make sure that our guests are fully aware of the menus that they offer there. So we'll be keeping these menus on the reception desk. So any guests that requires a booking in a restaurant, we can make the booking for them and actually provide a menu at the reception desk so they know exactly what's on offer.
And promoting these restaurants, are you also negotiating with the restaurants to provide guests with a discount?
This is something that we'd like to look at in the near future. We haven't got any discounts at the moment. However, this is something that we would like to investigate.
Okay. I mean, the same thing goes for the gym as well. It's one of those things, it's very difficult for a hotel, especially of this category, to put a gymnasium in. Yeah. But there are gyms in the vicinity of this hotel within walking distance. Mm-hmm. Do you have any plans to, for example, work with any of these gyms so that people can still maintain their fitness regime while they're here?
We would. What we would like to do is have an agreement with a local gym, as you mentioned. We have a number of gyms very close to the vicinity of the hotel. What we would like to do is work with them so the guests can actually purchase this at the reception desk and have full use. As I say, we don't have that at the moment, but as soon as we have this set up, it'll be put onto our website as well. So
right.
Be sure to check that out.
Excellent. Now, you mentioned earlier that the Westminster Hotel has experienced some amazing occupancy rates, 97% thereabouts for the 2011. Which markets will you be targeting here at this hotel?
Because of our location, we're very lucky that we can target the leisure industry, but also the corporate market as well. As I mentioned, the corporate market being so close to Bishopsgate, there's many head offices in this area. But at the same time, the leisure facilities in this area are fantastic. We're a short distance away from Tower Bridge and Tower of London, as well as the markets in this area as well. So there's plenty to offer for everybody.
Right. And which markets would you be expecting, for example, like the domestic UK market, the Asia Pacific markets? Which markets and what breakdown of percentages would you be expecting at the hotel?
Predominantly, the corporate market will be from the UK based. However, we are receiving bookings from the Asian market, being such a strong brand in Asia. And we're constantly looking at ways to look at the continental market, the European market, and further abroad as well.
Right. Now, of course, the concept behind the Tune Hotel is a 5-star sleeping experience, a 1-star price. Sounds very nice, but what does it mean?
This means that the beds that we provide are Hypnos beds. These beds are used in 4- and 5-star hotels here in London. We guarantee that every guest that comes to stay with us will have a great night's sleep, just because the beds are so comfortable. We also offer power showers as well. We understand it's very important for the guests to have a great night's sleep and in the morning to have a great shower to wake them up to start their day.
Oh, excellent. That sounds very nice. Now, in terms of the hotel as well, there are a lot of budget hotels. It's not just the Tune hotels. There are a lot of budget hotels in London as well as the rest of the UK. How does Tune differ then from these hotels, which tend to offer a complete package rather than an add-on service? How do you compete?
Well, what we like to do is give our guests the opportunity to build their own stay. We don't think it's right for a guest to pay for facilities that they might not be using. So this is how we differ from other budget brands. So when the guest arrives at the hotel, they pay for what they use, basically. It's very important to us to make sure that the guests are fully aware of who we are and who we're proud to be. So if you check out our website there, it will tell you all of our add-on services and how you can design your own stay with us. And that's what makes us unique in the marketplace in the budget hotels.
Right. Now, next year, you're going to be opening a very impressive garden courtyard area. What are you going to be doing with that?
Yes, we're in the process of building a kiosk in the garden where we'll be serving hot drinks, soft drinks and light snacks. And come the summer months here in London, we'll take full advantage of the garden where you can come and have your lunch in the afternoon or come and have a quiet drink with some friends. It really is a fantastic space and we're very proud of it.
So you envisage that will be open from breakfast or will it just be lunch and dinner?
No, it will be open from breakfast. 1st, the garden will close from 9:30 in the evening, so our guests and anyone in the area is more than welcome to come in and pay us a visit, and we'll be happy to see them.
Excellent. And finally, Mr. Clarke, I'd like to ask you, in terms of the Tune Hotel, obviously it's a very forward-thinking brand, what are your thoughts about this new trend of self-service, self-check-in facilities? What are your thoughts on those?
Yes, I believe that this would benefit some guests, especially our corporate market who are very busy. They can just come straight into the hotel and self-check in there. However, I do believe that it is important that we have people on the reception desk, so we have that face-to-face customer service that we're very proud of and what we pride ourselves on.
Right. Do you believe it's something that you could see at this hotel in the near future?
Absolutely. I think we're always looking at ways and how technology can help improve our service. So absolutely, watch this space.
Excellent. Well, Mr. Clarke, on that note, thank you very much indeed for your time today. And of course, best of luck at this brand new hotel.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.